When I first read the topic of this discussion, I thought it is quite wide and it will be a little bit like a river with no boundaries. But no, now after we have listened to the discussion, I had a second thought about it, that certainly it gives a lot of practical implications and sense to the topic which was raised today. It's not an academic topic. This is for us, practitioners of foreign policy, this is also very, very important. What is Europe now? What will become of Europe later? Where is the place of Russia in this Europe? Where is the place of European Union? What kind of European Union we shall have in the nearest future? More often than not, we hear that Russia is interested in the weak European Union. Not at all, because when the European Union is weak, it's accessible to additional pressure and reacts with sort of unpredictable actions. On the other hand, when the European Union, in my understanding, is overambitious, this is also bad, because it has a wrong impression about its own role and place in the changing international scenario, in the new balance of forces, which is now only in the process of making and formation. So the search for identity, this is a crucial issue for many nations and for European Union as well, and for international institutions operating in the European space. If you stick to be very conservative, like NATO, looking back all the time, you will have this sort of history repeating all the time and again about the so-called Russian threat, Russians are coming, Russians are doing this and that. If you have wider vision of the world and of Europe and of Russia in this world, then you'll try to find, to look for some new forms of cooperation and go beyond stereotypes. Stereotypes is a common challenge. It's very difficult to overcome them. And I guess here we have a lot to do, and practitioners and academics and historians have their share of responsibility in breaking these stereotypes. Rise of nationalism, is it good or is it bad? It's difficult to say, because to some extent, positive nationalism, this is a part of national identity. If it's diluted in a more general body, in a more general organization, or whatever you call it, if you have a loss of national identity, then what do you have? I don't know. It's an open question. There were big illusions about the problems of countries joining the EU, and these problems will go away in the framework of a new and very efficient body. Now we have the crisis in the EU. Some people here agree that this is crisis, some not, but anyhow, a crisis phenomena. But has the problems of these state members of the EU diluted or been diminished? To my mind, no. So you have on one hand race of nationalism, on the other hand you have globalization. A sort of golden middle, in my understanding, should be found here that may lead us to a more positive outlook and for more positive vision of the future. The question about Council of Europe was raised here a couple of times since we're here, in the territory of the Council of Europe. For us, it's an important body, and I agree with my colleagues here who were speaking about it. It is closely related with the issue of values. Somehow the issue of common values, European values, universal values became very politicized. And it's a pity, because universal values, the values of the human life, they're general. And certainly we do share these values, embodied also in the European Convention. The question now was not discussed, but it's somehow in the future about possibility of having the fourth summit of the Council of Europe. When I was personally thinking of the possibility, What would be the agenda of this idea, of this summit? Now, certainly, for that we need more confidence between ourselves. Now it's not very propitious. But maybe sort of a return to the initial values which united us after the war, sometime, to some extent. And then we distorted in the times of the Cold War. So to some extent, back to future. We have to think in both ways and be creative. And thank you very much for coming here. I think this is a really very important brainstorming exercise, which gave a lot of thought. And certainly, I feel that we didn't have much time, but we certainly appreciate your personal time. And thanks again for the organizers, for you, Mr. Kutuba, for moderating, and certainly for our guest speaker. And let's wish him a good success, because he is the head of a very important institution in my country. And being a scholar himself, he is also a practitioner. Let's wish him success. Thank you.